Rick. To my immediate left, Pittsburgh head coach Susie McConnell-Cirio. To her left, senior Brianna Kiesel, followed by graduate student Monica Wignott and freshman Stacia Carey. Coach Cirio will make an opening statement, and then we'll take questions from the student athletes. When we're done with those questions, we'll dismiss them to go back to the locker room, and then you can ask questions of Coach Cirio. And now I'll let Coach Cirio make her opening statement.
Well, the excitement certainly hasn't worn off from our victory yesterday. As we move forward, we are even more excited to be playing in the second round. And I don't know that any of us would have envisioned having the opportunity to play Tennessee on their home floor in this second round of the NCAA tournament. And we know that poses a great challenge, but with it a great opportunity, where our players will continue to prepare just like we have for any other opponent all year long. And we will play with everything to gain, nothing to lose. And we'll still be excited about that opportunity. We know this will be an incredible environment, and I want our players to enjoy this incredible opportunity.
We'll take questions for the student athletes, and if you would, please identify yourself with name and outlet. Go ahead, Mike.
Brianna, 2 years ago, where the program was, did this seem possible?
2 years ago, it was a lot. You know, we were struggling a little bit, and no, I couldn't have envisioned that we would have, you know, been in second round NCAA tournament. But I'm happy that we are here now.
To follow up on that, I was reading up that you were considering maybe transferring, just tired of losing, maybe go somewhere where you could win.
Yeah, I did. I thought about it. I graduated in 3 years, and you know, so I didn't have to sit out. But luckily for Coach, she talked me out of it, and she made me believe in her system. And you know, look at us now. She just, you know, she made a promise to me. She said that my senior year was going to be something special. And, I mean, she's a woman of her word. And I mean, that just goes to show that we're in the NCAA tournament second round. So for everyone that's coming in, make sure you believe what she says.
John.
Yeah, for Monica and Stacia, could you talk about the challenge that Tennessee's rebounding presents? I think they had an 18-rebound advantage against Boise.
Watching film on them, we've obviously seen that, you know, they have very big post players and very good post players. So defense for us is going to be a huge thing, you know, just playing big in the post, you know, being strong. So I think one of our main goals, I know, is big, is going to be boxing out. So that's one of our main objectives going into this game.
Yeah, Monica pretty much said it all. Rebounding is going to be key to helping our team. Getting big in the post and limiting their post players on the rebounds they get.
Steve?
Stacia. Is it Stacia or Stacia?
Stacia.
Sorry.
It's fine.
I'm just wondering, yesterday you were a freshman playing your first NCAA tournament game. After playing as well as you did yesterday, just how much more comfortable, confident are you going into this next game, or does it make any difference?
It doesn't really make a difference. I've been playing since the beginning of the season, so I'm a lot more comfortable than I was at the beginning of the season. The way I played yesterday just gives me more confidence in knowing that I can, the ability that I have to help my team out. The way I played, it's going to affect the way my team plays and their atmosphere too. So,
Mike?
Monica, when Coach approached you about coming out for basketball, I read that you originally, it didn't sound like a good idea to you.
Well, towards the end of volleyball, I was, like you said, I was pretty much done being a college athlete. I just kind of wanted to graduate, you know, get my degree and, like, kind of go into the real world. But really, when I reached that point, I didn't have a plan. I didn't really know what I was going to do. So when the opportunity came about, to go and play another year of basketball under Coach Cirio, I couldn't turn it down. It was a really good opportunity presented and probably a smart one that I went with. And I'm extremely happy that I did, so glad to be here.
Okay, you hadn't played basketball for so long. What kind of expectations did you have?
I set them really low for myself, considering, I honestly hadn't touched basketball in 4 years, so I really didn't know why they were asking me in the first place, because I was like, they don't even know, I don't know. I didn't really know what to expect for myself, so I just kind of went in, just trying not to have any pressure on myself, just have fun, you know. Again, I didn't play in 4 years, so I didn't know what I was going to look like, what I was going to play like. So I went into it trying to get better each day, not worry about if I was doing well or doing bad, just kind of having fun with it. Since I was only going to be there for 1 year, I was just trying to take it with a grain of salt and just do the best I can with what I had.
Matt?
Matt Slavin, Tennessee. And for any of you, when the bracket came out, was this a matchup that you immediately focused on and maybe even one that you wanted?
Well, when we first got the bracket, our first opponent was Chattanooga, so that's what we really focused on. And, I mean, Tennessee, I mean, they're playing on a home court. This is a remarkable facility here. So just to have the opportunity to play against, you know, one of the top teams in the nation is just something that's going to be special for all of us.
Tony?
Station mainly to you. How much more comfortable are you going to be tomorrow night getting that tournament game under the way? I mean, you guys started out very hot on yesterday, 11-2, but how much more comfortable, maybe no more nerves, tomorrow night?
I think I'll feel less nervous. I was a lot nervous yesterday. I don't know. I mean, I'm just going to come out and play with all I have. I mean, we have nothing to lose. I know I can depend on my teammates, and we're all in it together.
Well, the coaches, they know the scout inside and out. They know the team. They know what we're good at. They know who to go to. And they have certain plays where, you know, they know that if someone wants to get a touch, what plays to run. And if someone's having the hot hand, whether it be Fred or Monica or Stacia, the coaches are on it. They make sure that we make sure we get them a good shot. And, you know, whether we're having a defensive change, I know sometimes I may not be having the best defensive game, and coach can move someone over it, so that way it takes a little bit of pressure off of me. And also, if they're pressuring the ball full court, coach will have someone set an eyeball screen to try to alleviate a little bit of the pressure. But, I mean, that just goes to show how our coach staff really knows us, and they know the team inside and out.
Dustin.
Just for any of you guys, how did you guys view Tennessee as a program growing up, you know, playing basketball? I guess what does it mean to play against them in the tournament?
Oh, man, I was a fan. For the longest, I thought I was going to be as tall as Candace Parker for a second, but something happened. I just stopped growing. We had the same number and everything. She was someone that I looked up to, and, of course, Coach Summit. I mean, you just can't. Everything that she's done here, this is just such a historic place to play in, and to have the opportunity to play here, it's just like, wow, you're a 10-year-old looking at this phenomenal program, and now you're actually playing on the court, and it just means a lot to me.
I can say the same. Growing up, obviously, you know Pat Summit and her great career that she had as a coach, and great players such as Candace Parker. So I think it's kind of an honor to, you know, play on this court. It's almost like a once-in-a-lifetime experience, so I'm definitely excited about it.
Any other questions for the student-athletes? Steve.
What made you decide on Pittsburgh first, and also just what were your expectations coming in for your freshman year? What did you think was realistic?
I was really in love with the coaching staff when they were at Duquesne. They had my heart. Then I went on and I seen how much the program needed help, and I figured it was a good opportunity for myself. I really enjoyed the players when I got to visit them. And I also knew that, you know, Coach was a WNBA player. She's been coaching for many years, so she's obviously doing something right. Yeah. Yeah, she did. But I was young. I wasn't really paying attention to that. I was like, oh, basketball. Yeah, I'm getting a scholarship. Let me go play here. I like it. They got great colors. Coaching staff is awesome. Let me go here. Yeah, she was awesome during the recruiting process. And I don't know, I just fell in love with it, everything.
Any other questions for the student athletes?
I don't even know how to follow that.
I don't think you can.
I'm sorry.
Any other questions for them? All right, ladies, thank you very much.
Thank you.
You have to love her personality. I mean, that's what she brings to this team first and foremost, is that personality.
Okay, we'll go ahead and take questions for Coach Cirio now, down here.
Talk about how well she played yesterday and maybe the importance of her maybe acting as a spell gap for
You know, Asia played yesterday like we had seen her play earlier in the season, where she was able to hit those timely jumpers. And Asia, you know, Yassine and Stacia came in and had earned a starting spot right from the beginning of the for the season. Asia, I think, was inserted three games in, and she earned it. You know, the one thing that she brings is she does alleviate some of that pressure off of Brianna Kiesel with having another primary ball handler on the floor. Bree gets defended sometimes 94 feet, and she's defending 94 feet, so she's expending so much energy. She plays close to 40 minutes a game for us. So Asia alleviates some of that pressure of having to handle the basketball for 40 minutes, and it allows us to put her in a situation where Bree can now play the two guard, and we can run sets where she's the one coming off the screens, and we're looking to get her shots as opposed to always having that pressure. But Asia does the little things. You know, sometimes they go unnoticed. I mean, she guarded Shampert, 25. I was a numbers person with this team. And she was coming off of a career-high 25 points, and she contained her. She's smart, and she understands personnel. She studies the scouting report and does exactly what we need her to do.
Steve.
You know, rebounding is always a huge stat for us. We know we're not deep. We know we're not a very physical team. And sometimes we get taken advantage of on the boards, it's no doubt. And it's always been an emphasis from day one with rebounding the basketball. And, you know, watching Tennessee on film, watching Tennessee yesterday live, I mean, their post players are so strong. They're active. Even their guards, they pursue the basketball. They give themselves second and third chances. And that was in our film session we talked about is they make a living on the offensive glass. And we didn't do a great job yesterday giving them second chances, especially late in the game against Chattanooga. And that is something that is definitely needs to improve for us to even compete in this game.
Dan.
You know, this is a team that loves a routine when we go on the road. You know, people have asked us, you know, have you been out and about in Tennessee? Have you gone to restaurants? Have you done this? And they are creatures of habit. You know, the furthest we've gone is to this gym and back on our bus, and I walked across the parking lot to the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame. We eat at the hotel. They've been able to spend time with family. You know, they just have come across a routine that has worked for them. And, you know, I think that's the mindset that I try to have is confidence comes from being prepared. And so the preparation that we put into each opponent, our players get a sense of confidence going in at any game. And I know we're an underdog, so and they know it. You know, they watched ESPN yesterday and heard Kara Lawson and Rebecca Lobo talk about us not really having a chance. And so these players are motivated knowing that we're an underdog. We always play that up. So we'll play with everything to gain, nothing to lose. We respect Tennessee in every aspect. They have a tremendous team. They have so many scoring weapons that you have to respect each and every player on the floor. But our players will not fear them. And they'll go out, and I hope they won't anyway. You know, our goal is to compete for 40 minutes. You know, regardless of what the scoreboard is, our players will give their best effort.
Mike.
Mike Strange from Knoxville News Channel. Susie, since Stacia doesn't remember, could you kind of summarize what your chance was against this really good recruiting class coming off a not so good season?
Well, she wasn't lying. We needed a lot of help. you know, it was, you know, promoting and convincing them of having the opportunity to play immediately. And we know how important that is for players now. And you see players transferring all the time because they believe they can go anywhere and be an impact player immediately. Well, we weren't kidding with our freshmen that they would have an opportunity to come to Pitt, play right away, be impact players. We threw them into the fire from day one. And we have depended on them. So, you know, that was a big selling point. And then we're playing in the ACC. arguably the best conference in the country. I know I'm in SEC territory, but you know, we got eight teams into the tournament, and in the first round, the ACC had gone 8-0. So we believe that, you know, our goal was to get to the middle of the pack, and we believe that competing in the ACC has prepared us for this moment. It was. I mean, if you look back, I mean, we were coming off of a 3-13 conference season, and we were 11-20 overall. But we had lost a lot. Players had moved on, and we had Bree coming back with the addition of Monica, and Cora was. Those were the three seniors we would have. Our junior class, we don't even have any players. They're both injured. Two sophomores, and then we had three freshmen. So when you look at throwing that group together, we had no idea how quickly they would gel, the chemistry they would develop. And, you know, when we started playing games, I'm thinking, maybe we can make the WNIT. And because they started to develop chemistry, they started to buy in, you know, the focus for scouting reports. And then, you know, we get into conference play and we started competing with, you know, Louisville. We had an opportunity to beat at home. We beat North Carolina. We just continued to get better and better as a team. So, you know, postseason seemed a viable option, never envisioning that in our second year we would be in the NCAA tournament and now have the chance to play in the second round. It was a great trip. I mean, they got to see the history of women's basketball and you know, some familiar faces that are in there, and it was very enjoyable. I think they really enjoyed going through there. Yes. And it was just, it was perfect. I mean, I think, you know, because they grow up watching these players that are in the Hall of Fame, and some of them are coaching, but, you know, they watch them in the WNBA. And, you know, we have some players that dream of playing in the WNBA and life after college. So it was just a good experience for our team.
Dustin.
I'm not as awestruck as some of the players. You know, I played against Tennessee when I was in college, and it was on our home floor. And then I trained here with the Olympic team. And I know the history of this program, and I know everyone. It's Pat Summitt. It's her court. It's the history of the program. But, you know, I have to give Holly Wark the credit I have to give her is tremendous. She has done an amazing job taking over this program and putting her handprint on this program and maintaining the success that they've had, which isn't easy. It's not easy to take over someone like Pat Summitt. And I think Holly Wark has done a tremendous job. I think she's an amazing coach, and her teams play with so much fire and passion and energy. And seeing that up close and personal yesterday, because when you watch a team on film, it's so different than seeing them live. And I was impressed with what I saw yesterday with their team.
Steve.
I think with Stacia, the growth that she has made over this entire year is the confidence level that she is playing with. Because, you know, when you come in as a freshman, you never expect to be a go-to player inside. And we have been trying to develop her, you know, as a go-to player. When we need a basket, we're looking to go to the rim. And so many times it's putting the ball in the hands of Brianna Kiesel. And, you know, as the season has gone on, teams know that. And so to have another player that you can depend on, and for her to want the ball. She is not someone, when I watch other players post up and they're big and wide and strong and fighting for position, and that's not Stacia's game. I mean, she's not a physical post player. She prefers to be a face-up. She prefers to be on the perimeter. But we have asked her to do that and have that versatility of being able to do both, and she has responded. And I think she's just playing a lot more confidence this late in the season of wanting the ball inside.
Before, like, talked about basically going to the kitchen sink at 44 from Boise State yesterday, especially in the second half. Do you guys kind of expect that on Bree tomorrow, and kind of how do you guys plan on combating the really tough backcourt defensively from Tennessee to try and make sure Brianna can get some opportunities to help you guys?
You know, they're so good defensively. I mean, they're aggressive, they're quick. They play great help defense, and you know, for us, you know, you watch us play, you watch on film. It's no secret we run on ball screens for Bree, middle of the floor, side pick and roll, and you know, I've seen Tennessee support by their post players, the guards fight over. I've seen them switch, and you know, I would guess they would try a number of different things. They could trap her. I'm sure they're going to try and take the ball out of her hands. And, you know, that's when other players need to step up and be able to hit some shots for them to change what they do. And I think those are the adjustments and that we'll need to make as a team and as a staff. But if we hit shots, I think we'll have a chance.
Yeah.
You know, it's funny, not knowing that I would have a chance to play them. After our administrative meeting, she took me through the offices and showed me some of the facilities, and it's just so impressive. And her office is her office. I mean, it's her, and it's the players, and it's the team, and this is her program, and her picture is everywhere, in the hallways, in the practice court. I just think it has now come full circle where this is her program. I think as a coach, any coach, your job is to instill confidence in your players and give them the confidence that they can go out and compete with anyone that they are playing with. You see upsets happen all the time. I mean, in the men's game, in the women's game, when you toss that ball up, anything can happen. I mean, someone could get in foul trouble, an injury could happen, something can happen that changes the entire complexion of the game. You know, if we get off to a good start, it will give our players confidence to compete. But you know, we talk about our confidence coming from the preparation that we have gone into each game having. We watch personnel and sets. We did that last night. We watch your defense. We did that this morning. We'll watch their out-of-bounds plays. We'll do that before shoot-around tomorrow. We'll go through today in practice how we're defending their sets. We'll go through reviewing offense, and this is what we can look to expect. We know they press, we'll have a press breaker, they play a matchup zone, you know, just how we're looking to attack their different defenses that they will show. So it's all the preparation that our players have and the focus that they have going into every game, and that they're ready for anything. You know, if a team came out in a box and one, if they came out in a triangle and two, we've done things that we have seen it, and we can be prepared for it. Not always as successful as you'd like to be sometimes, but it's just your players having that confidence of being prepared for anything that someone throws at you.
Anything else? Dustin?
Robert, you mentioned the rebounding part. What else stands out to you about Tennessee on
ball? Rebounding will be huge. I mean, defending their on-ball screens, their motion, they are very good at moving without the basketball, with back doors. Their post-passing is tremendous. I mean, they see the next play, and that's the one thing that has stuck out in my mind is their players see the next play. I mean, it's in their hands, and the next pass is being made. It could be a back door. It could be a post-to-post entry. And, you know, we have to be ready to defend very, very well in their sets, being able to play out of their quick hitters because they just constantly are moving without the ball. Rebounding will be huge. But I think our struggles throughout the year have always been being able to score the basketball and be able to hit shots. And I think that's one of my biggest concerns is being able to score against their defense.
Mike.
Susie, just a thought on your bringing your sister on your staff. What's that like?
You know, it's been tremendous having the opportunity to coach with Kathy. You know, we've been in coaching for so long. She had, out of college, gone right into coaching at the collegiate level. And actually her first job was at the University of Pittsburgh with Kirk Bruce, who his daughter Carmen is now on my staff. So she's come full circle. And then she had gone on to Rutgers in Illinois with Teresa Grantz, and then was the head coach at Tulsa in Colorado. So she's always been in the college game. I started in high school for 13 years, went to the WNBA, and then had gotten into college. So we've kind of taken different paths through coaching. And then now to have the opportunity to have her on my staff, to have someone who knows the game, X's and O's, defense, being able to strategize with, you know, she's been a head coach, and so that experience, and she's been in the NCAA tournament. So, the, you know, just leaning on her on how things are done and what we need to do. And it's been really great, someone that I can trust, because I think when you have great chemistry on your staff, I think that's an indication of the success you can have, and your team feeds off of that. And we have great chemistry. I love our staff, and she fits right in. And it's been a great year of bringing her on and having her here. Great 2 years, actually.
Anything else? Okay, thanks, everyone.
Thank you.